basic proportionality theorem, BPT, the most important theorem in geometry for class 10th. It is also known as Thales theorem. What is basic proportionality theorem? First, see statement of this theorem. If a line is parallel to a side of a triangle which intersects the other sides in two distinct points, then the line divides those sides in proportion. See again, if a line is parallel to one side of a triangle and intersect other two sides in two distinct points, then we have to prove here the line divides those two sides in proportion in same ratio. According to this theorem, first we have to draw one triangle. Consider this triangle drawn on board with vertices P, Q and R. So this is triangle PQR. Line L is drawn here such that it is parallel to side QR of this triangle PQR. It intersects other two sides of this triangle at two distinct points. Side PQ at point M and side PR at point N. Now, to prove this theorem, we have to write given, then to prove, construction and proof. Now, first see what we have to write in given. As first we have drawn here triangle PQR, and in this diagram we draw one line L which is parallel to side QR. So we have to mention these things in given. In triangle PQR, line L parallel to side QR. Also, line L intersects side PQ and side PR in points M and N respectively, such that P dash M dash Q means P and Q, these three points are collinear and M is between P and Q. Also P dash N dash R means P and R, these three points are collinear and N is in between P and R. Now see what we have to prove in this theorem. As we know, line L parallel to one side of this triangle PQR, it is parallel to QR, and we have to prove that it divides other two sides, means side PQ and PR, in the same ratio, in the same proportion. Means we have to prove that PM upon MQ, this ratio is equal to PN upon NR. The ratio PM upon MQ, PM upon MQ is equal to PN upon NR, PN upon NR. Now see what construction we have to do in this case. Join segment QN and segment RN. So we have to join first segment QN and segment RM. Now we have to see proof of this theorem. In triangle PMN and triangle QMN, in these two triangles, if we will consider their base as PM and MQ both on the same line, then they have a common height from vertex N. From vertex N, they have a common height because their bases are on same line PM and MQ. Because of their common height, we can say that their areas are in proportion with their bases. Means ratio of their areas is equal to ratio of their bases. So we can write area of triangle PMN upon area of triangle QMN is equal to PM upon MQ, ratio of their bases. Reason: triangles having equal heights. This is statement number one. Similarly, in triangle PMN and triangle RMN, by taking bases PN and NR on the same line for these two triangles, they have a common height from vertex M. So, area of triangle PMN upon area of triangle RMN is equal to ratio of their bases PN upon RN. With same reason, triangles having equal heights. This is statement number 2. We have to prove that PM upon MQ is equal to PN upon RN. Means we have to prove right hand sides of statement 1 and 2 are equal. So to prove the ratios of their right hand sides are equal, first we have to prove the ratios of left hand sides are equal. Now just see the right hand sides of statement 1 and 2. Both have common numerator at their left hand sides. Area of triangle PMN is common at their numerators. Means to show their left hand sides ratios equal, we have to prove only their denominators are equal. Now just think about their denominators, area of triangle QMN and area of triangle RMN. Now see in diagram, these two triangles QMN and RMN have common base MN. Common base MN, and both are located between two parallels, line L and line QR. That means they have common height. Now see, they have common base MN and they have common height. If base and heights are same, sure their areas are equal. Means we can write area of triangle QMN is equal to area of triangle RMN. With reason, these triangles have common base MN and same height because they are located between two parallels. This is statement number 3. Therefore, we can write area of triangle PMN upon area of triangle QMN is equal to area of triangle PMN upon area of triangle RMN. These ratios are equal because they have common numerator as area of triangle PMN and their denominators are equal according to our statement number 3. Therefore, as the left hand sides of equation 1 and 2 are equal, we can write their right hand sides are also equal. If their left hand side ratios are equal, their right hand side ratios are also equal. So the right hand side ratio of statement 1, PM upon MQ, is equal to right hand side ratio of statement 2, that is PN upon NR. Reason from statement number 1, 2 and 3. Hence, the theorem of basic proportionality is proved.